The Waves Audio Studio Rack plugin is a free plugin by Waves in which you can create your own effect chains which are highly customizable. In this video, we're gonna look how it works and how it can be useful with and without other Waves plugins. Hi, I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you know when there's a new video online to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. In my Waves OVox review, check it here, I was talking about how it felt like a Lego building kit. A bit from this plugin and a bit from this plugin to create a new plugin. The Studio Rack plugin is the ultimate Lego building kit. You need Waves building bricks, the plugins to create your own effect chains. Let's first start off with the very first big butt of this plugin, and I cannot lie. The plugin chaining only works with other Waves plugins. Except there's a way to use this plugin without any other Waves plugins, and I will show you that at this timecode. Here's the track. I'll show you the basic functions and how it works. How crazy you can get is 100% dependent of which Waves plugins you have, and I do not own all Waves plugins. Okay, you have rack, macro and all view screens. Let's stick to all. And I will use it on the synth. I'll insert an EQ in the first slot of the rack and boost some of the lower end. I'll add a compressor in the second slot and adjust it a bit. And in the third slot, I'll add a delay. Until now, it just works as your standard inserts in any DAW. But here comes in the power of this plugin, and that is the macro controls. These controls can be set up to macro control multiple settings over multiple plugins. You can do that in three ways. First is to go to the macro and click on it and select a parameter from the plugins, which can be a lot to wade through. Second is to click assign over here. Open a plugin and click on any parameter you want to control. Or, and that is how I prefer it, you can also right click on any parameter in a plugin and add a macro slot to the controller. Let's add more parameters. I want the compression to be linked and the amount of delay. And I'll add the macro from the control inside the plugin. For some reason it only opens one plugin at a time. When I now use the macro, I will control all of these parameters at the same time. The EQ boost is now getting narrower, but I want it to get wider when I increase the macro knob. To achieve that, I go into the edit menu. Here you see all parameters I've assigned and you can change the behavior for each parameter. You already noticed this can go pretty deep, and you can have up to 8 parameters to change up however you want. I'm barely scratching the surface here on what you can achieve. Okay, one more example on what you can do in mixing. Again, let's use the master bus. Say I have an EQ on the master bus and a limiter. I want a quieter, thinner part and increase loudness while retaining the high frequencies. So I link this knob to macro 1, and the same for the top 2 EQ bands of this API EQ. When I now turn down macro 1, the volume gets less, but the high end increases. And when I turn it up, the high end decreases and the loudness increases. So I'll add more low end, more limiting and keep the high end about the same. that is useful for creating more movement in a mix. So without any other plugins, what is the use of Studio Rack? You can use it as a multi-band stereo width adjuster and as a sort of a simple remixer. Let me show you how. I'll insert the multi-band split module and add up to 5 bands. You set the crossover points between every band, and with this dial here, you can make each band smaller or wider. You can even do a complete flip of the stereo image on a band. With this flipping of the stereo image on a band, you can even change, for instance, the panning of a hi-hat on a mix. Let me show you how. You can correct the volume of each band with either input gain or output gain, of course, if you use it in this fashion. You can also flip the phase for each band. And when you first insert the parallel split, you get even more possibilities, because then you can select from stereo, left, right, mid and sides for both channels. And add a multiband in that and tweak from there. That goes pretty deep. Let's do a parallel null test to see how good the filters are. So one track is normal and the other one will be phased reversed with the multiband on it. If you want to use parallel processing, you at least will know if the starting point is 100% phase correct. Let's do it inside Studio Rack. For that, I insert the parallel split and insert the multiband split in the first slot of the parallel track and reverse the phase. As you can hear, this is far from being a complete phase cancellation. Means if you want to be sure you have a perfect phase between the parallel track with the normal track, you have to do the following. You set the crossover bands to where you want the frequency bands, and you copy the multiband split into the clean normal track. As you hear, total silence, so the phase between the tracks is now perfect. I know this trick because I use the Waves C4 multiband. It has the same issue. It doesn't matter if you do this inside Studio Rack or use two completely separate tracks. The issue is the same. So even if you want to use one instance of multi-track, you have to duplicate it on the clean track to make sure that the phase is correct between the two tracks. You will probably introduce small phase differences anyway with different Wave plugins. So this setup can also be used to check which Waves plugins will also introduce small phase differences. I noticed when you copy the plugins back and forth a lot when using the Ctrl-Alt-Drag function in Cubase, I could break the plugin. So be careful with that. So with this plugin, complex setups are possible. Really complex setups. The main usage of using Studio Rack is, of course, when you already own Waves plugins. This plugin can speed up your workflow by having one macro knob doing all of the adjustments, which you then can automate instead of adjusting every parameter one by one. And even without any other Waves plugins, the Stereo Rack is very useful as an enhanced multiband stereo width tweaker. I'm thinking of coming up with some presets for this plugin. If you want me to do so, let me know in the comments. Check out my review of the Nugen Audio SigMod if you want to know more about another multi-tool. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!